Today we are not studying the dot product, but the things which are related with the dot product. Earlier, just we will take the review and then we will go ahead. Earlier we have already studied the dot product. Just at the first rate we will go ahead, and in that we have seen the if two vectors are there, vector A dot B is defined as A magnitude, B magnitude, cosine of theta. If this is vector A, this is vector B, and this is the angle between this vector A and B, then it is AB cos theta. Any vector can be represented as all three components as AX, AX, AY, AY, AZ, AZ. Similarly, the B vector can be represented as BX, AX, BY, AY, BZ, AZ. Right? Now, because our vectors are represented as component parts in X, Y, and Z directions, thus we must know the dot product of unit vectors, which we have already studied. Right? We have seen the AZ is AZ, AX, and AY. These are the unit vectors in different directions. X, Y, Z, and they are making the angle of 90 degree with each other, right? 90 degree. Thus, if we will see the dot vector of this AX dot AX, it is coming out to be, according to definition, AX magnitude, which is 1, AX magnitude, which is 1, cosine of 0, because AX is making 0 angle with another AX vector. So it is coming out to be 1. Similarly, we have already studied if we are having say AY, AY dot AY will also be 1 with the same reasoning. AZ dot AZ will also be 1 with the same reason, because the angle is 0. And we have seen, if we'll have say AX dot AY, it will be AX magnitude, AY magnitude, which is 1, 1, and angle is 90 degree, because AX and AY are making the 90 degree with each. So, because cos 90 is 0, so we'll get this AX dot AY as equal to 0. Similarly, this AY dot AZ will also be equal to 1. AZ dot AX will also be equal to 0 with the same reason, because they are making the angle of 90 degree. And in the class we have explained by our the significance of cosine, by our gesture also, just I am enhancing it here, and I will just elaborate. Just we are creating the just as we have taken the hands, right? Just I am elaborating here. What we have taken is, just we have taken the hands. Say if we are making the 0 angle, 0 degree. 0 degree is there, which means if angle is 0, the projection is full, cos value will be full. If the angle is 90 degree, the projection here will be 0. So in this manner we can easily remember, as we have already explained, cos is equal. Cos means horizontal projection. When the angle is 0, the horizontal projection is full. When angle is 90 degree, projection is here on the horizontal plane, projection is 0. So in this manner we can remember it. And we have understood last time
Now, we will go ahead and we have seen last time the dot product of a general vector which is coming out to be Ax, Ax, this Ax, 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 Bx, Ay, By, Az, Bz. And we have given some problems also. And we have calculated the dot product also last time of two vectors A dot B. And we have calculated this angle also between the two vectors. Then we have given another vector also, another problem, and we have calculated the different things for different vectors. And today we are going ahead. Aaj hum aage badhenge and we will erase this and we will go ahead today. So today we will go ahead with the vector position. Jaisa title mein bhi aapka likha hua hai. So I am clearing this earlier things. It will take some time. Okay. And today's topic of discussion is, as we have already pointed out, vector projection. And to explain this, we will consider one problem. So, we will start our discussion with question number 1. Given two vectors A equal to 5 AX plus 4 AY plus 7 AZ, and vector B as minus 2 AX plus 3 AY plus 2 AZ. Find A part, A dot B, B part, the angle between A and B, that is theta, C part, scalar projection. Scalar projection of A on vector P, and D part A is vector projection of A on B. And This part, the last part, is basically the today's understanding. So while we will go to the D part, at that point we will explain our vector projection definition also, and we will see how to calculate it, so that everything will be clear to you. Because from the point of view of examination, generally in the examination questions are there and you have to calculate the vector projection. That's why without wasting time in the theory, we are going ahead with the numerical problem, right? Say these two vectors are given to us. A vector A, say let this is the vector A and this is our vector B. This is vector B and this is vector A, which are making the angle of theta. Between the theta is the angle between A and B, and these three components of vector A as well as all three components of vector B are given to you. Now first part we will see, A part, we will use the A dot B. As we have seen, for calculating A dot B, the formula which we are knowing is AX BX plus AY BY plus AZ BZ. Thus, what are this? This is the AX will be equal to say 5. This BX will be equal to minus 2. So we will be having 5 multiplied by minus 2 plus we will have AY is 4. We will have 4 multiplied by BY, which is 3. Plus AZ will be 7 multiplied by BZ, that is 2, which will be equal to minus 10 plus 12 and plus 14, which will be equal to minus 10 over here, this is 2. 16. This will be 16. So A dot B is coming out to be 16. As when I am having the explanation, I cannot see the your shared box. Some of you might be calculating very fast also, but because at my end I have to manage the softwares, I have to see too many things, so we cannot go fast. I can go fast, but our softwares are not that much fast. So every time, for making everything clear, we have to move in the online somewhat. So our, now we have seen, we have calculated the first part, right? Now we are going ahead with the B part. In the B part, we have to calculate this angle theta, and we are knowing the formula for dot product is A dot B must be equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B and cos of theta. Thus, this A dot B we have already calculated, coming out to be 16. Thus, we can say this 16 must be equal to A magnitude, B magnitude and cos of theta. From there we can calculate cos theta, which means we have to calculate now magnitude of A. And as we are knowing, this magnitude will be of A will be AX square plus AY square plus AZ square, which will be equal to under root here. AX is 5, this one. Then we are having AY is 4, 5 square plus 4 square plus Z component is 7 square, which is coming out to be equal to, just will create the space. Yes, sufficient space is there. So we'll write it. This is coming out to be equal to, just I am using the calculator. I think you are also using it, might be fast. So from the calculator we can calculate it. 5 square is 25 plus 15 plus 49 will be coming out to be 90. Under root 90 is coming out to be equal to, the root 19, it is coming out to be equal to, just we'll go ahead, it's coming out to be 90. Is coming out to be equal to, some of you have already calculated angle also, good, no problem. We will see this, we will elaborate, because we have to take class into the place. We have to take all the kids to take care of them, so we can do it, so that everyone will be able to understand, right? So this root 90 will be equal to, this calculator actually ये पुराना है तो सब इसमें क्या erase हो गया है, तो अंदाज से calculate करना पड़ता है. और जैसा कि आप लोगों ने भी किया है, 9.48 आ रहा है, is coming out to be 9.48. So this is the value of A magnitude. Similarly, we can calculate the B magnitude, and this B magnitude will be equal to under root BX square plus BY square plus BZ square, coming out to be equal to under root, देखते जाइए x component, ये हो गया 2, 3 and 2, so it will be 2 square plus 3 square plus 2 square, 4, 4, 8 and 9 will be root 17, 4 point कुछ आ जाएगा, we'll go ahead, इसमें मिल गया है मुझे, जल्दी हो जाएगा. This is under root 17 equal to 4.123. So it is coming out to be 4.123. Now we will go ahead. अभी और आगे चलेंगे. So we can go ahead. Now we can write here these values in this formula. This 16 will be equal to A magnitude is 9.486. Then we are having B magnitude 4.123 and cos of theta. Thus, from here, from this formula, this one, AB cos theta equal to this, from equation number say this formula 1, we can calculate cos theta. This cos theta will be equal to 16 divided by 9.486 divided by 4.123, coming out to be 0.4090, coming out to be 0.409. Thus we can calculate the theta, which is cos inverse 0.4090, coming out to be equal to 65.857, or we can say 65 point, coming out to be 5.858 degrees. Let me check whether it is in degree or this. Yes, it is. It's correct. Some of you have already calculated it. Very nice. And now we will go ahead. So some of you have already calculated. Just I am going to the chat box. 65.85 has already been calculated by too many students. Namrata Sahu, Jim Pandey, Shantanu, then having Rahul Dubey, Harsh Sharma. Very good that you are taking interest, and we'll go ahead. Aage part karte hain. Scalar projection, C part. Right? We'll go ahead with the C part. As we have seen, the scalar projection, this quantity, the scalar projection of A on B, this will be equal to A cos of theta. A cos theta means A magnitude cos theta. This is defined as scalar projection. If we are seeing in the diagram, this projection, the projection of A on B, this distance is scalar projection. This distance is known as scalar projection, which is equal to A magnitude cos of theta. And now, because theta is also known to us, this, and A magnitude is known to us, we can calculate the C part. And here I am writing the C part. The C part will be scalar projection, which will be equal to A magnitude, as we have already calculated. A magnitude is 9.486, and cos theta also is known to us, cos of, as we have calculated, 65.58 degree. Thus this SP will be equal to, we can calculate here, the scalar projection will be 9.486 into 3.879. The scalar projection is 3.879. This is the scalar projection, and now we are going ahead with the vector projection. As scalar projection is a, as we have understood in the diagram, scalar projection is the length from here to here. From this point to this point. This is the scalar projection. Now vector projection, we will see the definition of vector projection, and then we will have the calculation. Vector projection, just I am speaking, we will write also, is a vector multiplied by scalar projection. This vector is a unit vector. So mathematically, this vector projection will be equal to scalar projection into a vector in the direction of B. This is very important. Which quantity? We have to remember this point, P, unit vector of B, because whenever this vector is to be, this A vector, this, if this vector is to be projected on B vector, this is the length, this is the length, and if we are multiplying it with the unit vector in this direction, it becomes a vector. Scalar projection is a scalar quantity, but vector projection is a vector quantity. So if it is multiplied by the unit vector in the direction of B, it becomes vector projection. Which means, if we want to calculate vector projection of A on B, so unit vector kiska lena hai, B ka lena hai. This is very important. Scalar projection multiplied by a unit vector in the direction of B. So vector projection is a vector. Now what will be the definition? If we will see the definition of vector projection, we can say it is a, thoda chota kar lete hain, the definition will be vector projection of a vector on other vector will be a vector having magnitude equal to scalar projection and its direction and its directed like that and directed towards other vector. That's all. Thus, we have written the definition also. Now we will see the calculation. As from this mathematical definition, it is clear. Vector position is scalar position multiplied by unit vector in the direction of B. We can calculate it easily. So we are creating the space here, and here itself we will calculate. So we are erasing this part, a part, जो कि बहुत simple था, सभी ने किया भी है, समझा भी है. And we are going ahead. ये भी complete हो गया हमारा. So now we will calculate the very important vector projection, and this vector projection of A on B will be, we are writing VP, vector projection of vector A on B will be mathematically equal to scalar projection which we have already calculated multiplied by a vector in the direction of B, which means it will be scalar projection multiplied by RB divided by RB magnitude. Okay, this unit vector is defined as vector divided by its magnitude. So for our today's problem, this vector projection will be equal to the scalar projection we have already calculated, this one, this is 3.879 multiplied by a unit vector, that is RB we are knowing. This B vector is minus 2ax plus 3ay plus 2az divided by its magnitude. We have already calculated magnitude. We will see this. Dekhte hain. Divide by its magnitude. Just I am taking the data. Magnitude of B is 4 point, as we have already seen. This one 4.123. So we will just divide it by 4.123. Thus, in this manner, we will create the space we can calculate the vector projection. And now I request some of the students to calculate the vector position. It will have all the three components. इसी को आपको calculate करना है. And I am switching to the chat box. And after seeing your answer, we will write the vector projection of A on B. So I request some of you to calculate this and write the answers in the chat box. Meanwhile, I am also seeing it. Right? So, all my dear students, already indicated by Rimjim, -1.88x, 2.82ay, 1.88az. Some more students may calculate this. ठीक है, रिमझिम ने तो किया ही है, तो हरदम कर ही रहे हैं आप, नो प्रॉब्लम इन दैट. बाकी स्टूडेंट भी कर रहे हैं, एंड सम ऑफ यू आर लिसनिंग माइट बी थिंकिंग, नो प्रॉब्लम, बट अदर्स आल्सो शुड इंडिकेट. शांतनु हैज इंडिकेटेड, तो शांतनु ने पूरा प्लस किया, माइनस साइन आएगा भाई शांतनु, कोई ठीक है बाकी है ना. हाँ हाँ ठीक है, बाकी ठीक है. चार विनीता हैज इंडिकेटेड सेम, माइनस 1.882 करेक्ट, 2.823 3 पॉइंट तक अपने को बताना है. तो विनीता वी कैन से दोनों के आंसर में करेक्शन अगर देखा जाए तो आर विनीता इज मोर करेक्ट, ऐसा बोल सकते हैं. 3 पॉइंट तक हमको लिखना है वेक्टर. ठीक है, आपने लिखा है सही, रिमझिम ने भी ठीक लिखा है, बट वी कैन से अप टू 3 पॉइंट वी शुड राइट ए वेक्टर जैसा कि आपने लिखा है. सिमिलरली प्रबीर रावत हैज ऑल्सो कैलकुलेटेड -1.88 +2.82 +1. बिल्कुल सही है, वेरी गुड. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट अदर स्टूडेंट्स आल्सो टू कैलकुलेट. वी आर सीइंग हियर वी आर हैविंग 8 कॉन्करेंट व्यूअर्स. इफ एनीथिंग इज नॉट क्लियर एट एनी स्टेज, you can write in the chat box, no problem in that. Every time, why after taking your feedback, we are improving our lecture qualities. So, we will be thankful to you. अगर मान लो जैसे मैं अंग्रेजी बोल रहा हूँ, मान लो आपको लगता है कि थोड़ा मुझे हिंदी बोलना चाहिए, जनरली मैं मिक्स बोलता हूँ, तब भी आप इंडिकेट कर सकते सर हिंदी. तो डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर इंडिकेशंस, जैसे मान लो मेजोरिटी चाहती है तो मैं हिंदी में भी बोल सकता हूँ, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. अभी और देखते हैं कुछ लोग. नम्रता साहू हैज आल्सो इंडिकेटेड, हाँ यस सर एक्चुअली 2 डिजिट्स आया, तो ठीक है कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, है ना, नो प्रॉब्लम. रिमझिम हैज रिटन, हाँ ठीक है ठीक है, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है भाई, नो प्रॉब्लम, कोई नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल, है ना. मेन थिंग इज योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, बट अप टू 2 डिजिट आल्सो रिमझिम ने कुछ लिखा है, ठीक है यार करेक्ट. हाँ -1. सत्यम हैज आल्सो गिवन द आंसर, कबीर रावत, नम्रता साहू एंड रिमझिम पांडे हैज रिटन द एक्सप्लेनेशन, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं रिमझिम, यू आर द सिंसियर स्टूडेंट, नो प्रॉब्लम. सत्यम तिवारी हैज आल्सो कैलकुलेटेड, हर्ष शर्मा हैज आल्सो कैलकुलेटेड, थैंक यू हर्ष, वेरी नाइस. आई रिक्वेस्ट अदर्स those actually say 8 concrete students should at least calculate and write everything in your notebook also, so that later on your notes will be prepared and you will find helpful, it will be helpful for you. Harsha Sharma has also indicated, Harsh Sharma has also indicated, and Shantanu has also indicated, yeah good. Very nice. And now it is the time to just give thumbs up sign at the chat box and you can leave the class because time is about to up. It is 1:21 ho gaya hai. So aapka time ho gaya hai. Classes are 1:30 tak hai. So main ek question likh deta hu. 1:40 se 1:40 one question I am giving as a homework, right? So wo homework aapko karna hai. मैं बुक से देता हूँ क्वेश्चन आपको, या ऐसे एक बना के देता हूँ क्वेश्चन, ठीक है. तो आई एम गिविंग यू वन होमवर्क टुडे, एवरी टाइम आफ्टर प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग आई विल गिव यू होमवर्क. होमवर्क भी आपको अपनी नोटबुक में करना है, ठीक है, जो नोटबुक आप बनाए हैं फील्ड के लिए उसी में करना है. एक मैं होमवर्क दे रहा हूँ आपको, फिर नेक्स्ट टाइम हम बुक से और प्रॉब्लम्स लेंगे और CSVT प्रॉब्लम्स लेंगे, ठीक है? तो जस्ट आई एम राइटिंग वन होमवर्क हियर ऑन द स्क्रीन, ये आपको करना है होमवर्क। तो होमवर्क क्वेश्चन आई एम राइटिंग होमवर्क टुडेज होमवर्क इज आवर दिस इज होमवर्क क्वेश्चन नंबर टू गिवन थ्री पॉइंट्स ए माइनस थ्री फोर माइनस टू बी जीरो सिक्स टू एंड पॉइंट सी एट टेन माइनस फाइव फाइंड ए पार्ट a vector r a b b part vector r a c c part distance between B and C, D part A unit vector directed from C to origin, E part perimeter of the triangle. Perimeter F part the dot product between RAB and RAC. Next part G part the angle theta between RAB and RAC. Next part H part scalar projection of RAB on RAC. Next part, I part. Vector projection of RAB on RAC. Next part, J part. Scalar projection of RAC on RAB. Next part, K part, and last part, vector projection of RAC on RAB. This problem you have to solve in your notebook. ठीक है, तीन पॉइंट दिए हैं, बाकी पार्ट्स हैं. और अगर मान लो कोई बना पाते हैं, अभी स्टार्टिंग का पार्ट तो बन ही जाएगा, RAB RAC. यू कैन इंडिकेट इन द चैट बॉक्स, बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग 2 मिनट्स, एक दो मिनट है हमारे पास.